Good afternoon, everyone. We will continue with chapter 7, Geography, which is India on the map. So in this one, we will discuss about political and administrative divisions. How politically India is divided, and how on the administrative basis, on the administration ground it is divided. So, as we know, India is a vast country. India is a vast country, right? So, it has political divisions. So, in that, how it is politically divided? Politically, it is divided. We have 28 states. Then we have 8 union territories. Then you have Delhi, which is the national capital. Then you have largest state. Largest state is Rajasthan. And then you have smallest state. Area wise. Smallest state, you have Goa. Okay. Dadar and Nagar Haveli. Earlier, these were two different union territories which now are combined. So it is one union territory now from 2020 Jan. Understood? So this is how we are having 28 states, 8 union territories. Then you have Delhi, which is your national capital. Then we have largest state, which is Rajasthan, and smallest state we have Goa. Okay. Now we will do some of the map work, and after that this chapter will be end. So we will start chapter 8, India physical features. So we'll go to map work now. So I think you people can see my this one. Just a minute. Everyone can see this, right? Now see, I told you to do map work, and you people always do mistakes in that. So for that, I just want to show you. So here you can see, this is the map of India. So when you are making the map, first you need to put heading here. I have given 4 headings in your homework. The same 4 headings you need to put here. 4 map will be drawn. So in each map, put 1 heading. Okay. And show whatever written. So this is the legend. See, this one is the legend. This is legend. So this is legend. Understood? So this is this legend, you need to make it at any of the corner, you will make it. Okay, so first we will understand the border sharing countries, neighbors of the India. So where, for with which countries we are sharing borders? So we'll start from the top. Here you see, this is Afghanistan. Here we are sharing border with the Afghanistan. Okay, so Afghanistan is our border sharing neighbor. This border is shared with the Afghanistan. Then you have Pakistan. Very long border area we are sharing with the Pakistan, this area. Understood? So very long border area is being shared with the Pakistan. Then with Nepal also, here we share the border. Right? Then you have Bhutan. We share the border with Bhutan also. Then you have Bangladesh. Bangladesh also share the border with our India. Then you have Myanmar. Myanmar also share the border with India. Then you have China. This area we share here, and this area with China. This area is also shared with the China till here. So all this area is being shared by the China, this one. So here you can understand that our border sharing neighbors are Afghanistan, Pakistan, then you have Bangladesh, then you have Myanmar, then you have Nepal, Bhutan, then you have China. With all these countries, we share our border. Okay. So you people can do this one. This map, now you understood and you can do this map work. Next is landlocked neighbors. So basically we told that landlocked neighbors are the neighbors which do not have sea route. In this, you can see Afghanistan. Afghanistan, if you will take, it is having land all around it. All around it, it has land. So it does not have sea route. So either it has to go like this from Pakistan, either it has to go from India. So from India, it takes a long time. It is a long route. So basically, Afghanistan takes the route from Pakistan and other countries. Okay, now you have Nepal here. Nepal is also a landlocked neighbor. You see, everywhere land is there. Here you have sea. To reach to sea, it has to go from India. Okay, then you have Bhutan. Bhutan also is landlocked, and you see, it also has to take a path from the India to go to the sea, to take a sea route. Understood? So like this, we discussed about landlocked neighbors. These are the landlocked neighbors which do not have the sea route. If they want to go to sea, they want to take the sea route, they has to go from the India. Okay, so in that you have Nepal, Bhutan, okay, Afghanistan also sometimes, but most of mostly Afghanistan will take it from the Pakistan because it is near from that place. Now you have sea neighbors. Sorry, you have island neighbors. So in island neighbors, we have Sri Lanka and Maldives. So here you see, this is Sri Lanka, which is an island surrounded by water. Then here you have Maldives. It is also surrounded by water from all the sides. They are island and they are our island neighbors. Now you would be thinking about Lakshadweep and Andaman Nicobar. So Lakshadweep and Andaman Nicobar are part of India. Understood? They are union territories in India. Okay? They are part of India. They are not different from India. But Sri Lanka is not part of India. It is different country and it is our island neighbor. The same way Maldives, not part of India. It is different island and it is our island neighbor. Okay? Now you have straits. So where are straits? That you need to understand. So here you have Park Strait. This is the Park Strait. This narrow border, narrow passes of water you see between Sri Lanka and India. This is Park Strait. This Park Strait joins Bay of Bengal. It joins, this is Bay of Bengal and this is Arabian Sea here. And here you have Indian Ocean. Downwards, here you have Indian Ocean. This side, here you have Indian Ocean. So it basically joins the Indian Ocean to Bay of Bengal. Understood? It joins Indian Ocean to Bay of Bengal. This narrow passage. This is Park Strait. This is Park Strait. Understood? And it also separates India and Sri Lanka. Any question in understanding all these terms? Anyone? Anyone is having any question in understanding all these terms? Fine. So we will start new chapter. Okay, administration part, I need to make you understand. The division which we discussed now, that was political division. Okay, that means states, borders and all, capitals, those things are political division. That means the border, the state borders and country border, all that is political division. If we are talking about administrative division, that means to govern the country, how the government is divided, that is, you see, first we have center, then you have state, then you have district. Okay, so on three levels our government is divided. First is center, which is often called union or central government. Understood? Then you have state government, then you have district. So center is the uppermost, topmost government. Then under center government you have state governments. Many states are there, 28 states are there. They have their own government. Understood? After that, in the state there are many districts. So on the district level also we have DM and governance is being done. Okay. So like this, on the administration basis, India is divided. It is divided into three levels: central level, state level, district level. Understood? So on central level we have prime minister, administrative, executive, and then you have on state level CM, who is the head executive body, head of the executive body. Then you have on the district level you have DM, who is the head of the executive body. Understood? So in center, head is PM, executive body, head is PM. On the state level you have CM, chief minister. Then on the district level you have DM, okay, district magistrate, often called collector. Now we discussed about political features. Now we will discuss about physical features. This is your next chapter. Physical features. Okay. That is chapter 8 of geography. Okay. So basically, physical means the whatever you can touch, that is physical, right? So physical features, what we have? We have diversity in the physical feature. We have diversity of physical division. So how is that divided? It is divided in like you have mountains, that is physical feature. Then you have plateaus, that we have already discussed all these things in the previous chapter, different landforms, physical features of India. Now we are only discussing those terms in the context of our country. Earlier we discussed in general mountain, plateau, other things. Now we will discuss in context with in terms of India. Okay, so mountains, plateaus, plains, then coastal plateaus, coastal plains, and islands. So all these things we have in our country. So in mountains, if you see, main mountain we have Himalayas, right? So we will discuss about Himalayas. Then you have in plains you have northern plain. We will discuss and you will see where do we have northern plain. Then if plateau is there, we have peninsular plateau. Where is this peninsular plateau? That we will discuss. Then you have coastal plains. Coastal plains are there on the western coast and plains. Okay, then island also we have Andaman, Nicobar, and Lakshadweep. Nicobar, and then you have Lakshadweep. So these islands are also there. Then you have, yes, all the things we have discussed. Then you have Great Indian Desert, that is also there. Great Indian Desert. So Great Indian Desert is also there. So we will discuss where is this. Okay. And about all these landforms we will discuss. Okay. So first, let's see all these physical divisions, all these landforms, where do we have? So here you see the blue color. If you see this blue color is Himalayas. Understood? You have Himalayas till here. Like this, you have Himalayas. Okay? That is in the northeast. You have Himalayas. In the northern area of the northern direction of the India, you have Himalayas. Then you have plain, northern plain. So this green one is northern plain. This green color is northern plain. Understood? Then you have the highlands. Highlands is also plateaus. So you have central highlands. That means central plateaus. That is called central highlands. So this is your central highland, that is also plateau. Then peninsular plateau, which we discussed, is this one. This is the peninsular plateau. This brown color is peninsular plateau. Okay. Then you have the coastal plains. So on the west coast also, this pink color, you have plain, coastal plain. And this yellow color also is the coastal plain. This is the eastern coastal plain. This is eastern coastal plain and this one is western coastal plain. Understood? This pink color is western coastal plain. This is eastern coastal plain. Okay. Then you have islands. You have islands. Here you have Lakshadweep. Here you have Andaman Nicobar. So these are islands. Now the Great Indian Desert. So here you have Great Indian Desert, this area. Okay. So this area here you will having the Great Indian Desert. Okay. So I hope you all understood. When I will give the map work to show different landforms, you will not mistake it. Okay. This blue color is Himalayas. Then this green color is the Great Plain, Northern Plain. Then this is the Central Highland, dark purple. This brown color is the Peninsular Plateau. Then this pink color is the East Coast Plain, East Coastal Plain. Then this is the Western Coastal Plain. Varsha Kumari. Then you have the Great Indian Desert and islands, Andaman Nicobar, and this side you have Lakshadweep. Understood? So like this, we have the landforms, physical features of India. Understood? Any question, anyone in this one? Any questions? Okay. So first feature is Himalayas. So we will discuss about Himalayas. Okay. Map you have to always remember. Always remember the map. It will help you to connect the things. Now Himalaya. Himalayas is made up of Him plus Alaya. Alaya. It is in Hindi. Hindi. These are Hindi words. Him plus Alaya. Him means birth, snow. Him means birth, snow, and Alaya means ghar, house. Understood? Home. That is Alaya. So, if you combine this Him and Alaya, the meaning of this is the abode of snow. The abode of snow. Abode means home, house. Okay? House. So Himalaya is basically the abode of snow, that means house of snow. Understood? You need to remember this. Himalaya is made up of Him plus Alaya. Him and Alaya are the Hindi word. Him means birth, snow. Alaya is house, home. So the meaning of this is the abode of snow, that means house of snow. Understood? Now, if you see, the Himalayan mountain is divided into three parts, three main parallel ranges. Main parallel ranges. So, what is a mountain range? We have already discussed in the previous chapter. What is mountain range? Chain of mountains. Chain of mountain is called mountain range. So it is divided into three main parallel ranges. What are those? First is the Great Himalaya. The Great Himalaya or Himadri. The Great Himalaya or Himadri. Then you have the Middle Himalaya. The Middle Himalaya. Or Himachal. Then you have Shivali. These are the three mountain ranges in which this is divided. Himalaya is divided. So it is the Great Himalaya or Himadri. It is also called Himadri. The Middle Himalaya or Himachal. And most of the mountain hill stations you will find in Himachal. Most of the hill stations will be found in the Middle Himalaya. Then you have last one, Shivali. So how is this? You need to understand. If suppose this is India, this here you have Himalayas. So the first one, this range is the Himadri. Understood? Then middle one is the Himachal. Then the last one towards our country is Shivali. Okay. So like this it is there. Understood? Any question anyone till here? If you have any question, please ask quickly. Huh? Any question anyone? Okay, thank you everyone for today.